Hi, Stan with 3D PT. So, a new thing's come across the news and just exploded on Zillow. So, it's a 3D print home that's now for sale in Riverhead, New York. 3D printing homes have been around for probably usually about 10, 20 years. But really, the technology has not been democratized because most of the people that have the technology have been focused on just selling the printers, but they haven't been focused on actually just printing homes and selling them. But a company called SQ4D has actually been working behind the scenes for the last few years to get their technology down and a home permitted and printed. The biggest challenge for home printing has actually not been the technology, because that's basically just a controlled cement pump. It has been, how do you get it coated and approved for occupancy and for sale? So I'm just going to do a couple look over things. So SQ4D is based in New York, and they have an entire universe of systems to print homes, print homes. And they listed their home on Zillow for $300,000 for a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,407 square foot home. It's a new construction, so $300,000 for a home for a 3-bed is actually, as I understand, that's below market value, or below market value. So just within a day, they listed it. So they're listing as the first home for sale using their patented ARCS technology. It's got 3-bed, 2-bath, with a 2.5-car detached garage designed by H2M. And it exceeds all energy efficiency codes and lowers energy cost. So that's been a big thing with this, is once you print a home, it's going to, you can put a lot of insulation in between it. The cement itself is pretty good at insulating. Plus, you could do different geopolymer mixes that also help with insulation. In terms of weathering and everything, this is definitely going to be a lot stronger. So you don't have to worry about wood rotting, breaking down, a lot less risk of fire. And in theory, the cement could be recycled. So you could take old cement, grind it up, recycle it. So that would be something for later. You could take a tour on Zillow's, so it'll have to be you have to schedule a video one. I'm not going to do that. But yeah, it's listed as single family, and cost per square foot is $213. It's on a 1/4-acre lot. It does have the private 2.5-car garage. And it is a ranch style. So I think another thing that might have scared some people off is the fact that you can make such radical home designs. But you have to remember things like your roofing, furniture, are all built pretty standard for a square box house. So having a ranch style house is kind of industry recognized, which I think is a good way to transition from traditional housing designs into some of the more radical designs like what you've seen in the past with Avis Core or some other print home designs. Let's see. So it is considered green. It has construction green energy elements, so it has insulated concrete forms. And it'd be interesting to go look at this more in detail and if they release how they did that. Let's see. All the other details here. So this is very exciting because you have a 3D print home that's coated and meets local standards and is permitted and ready for sale and occupancy. When you can make a new home, and $300,000 is probably just a high retail price. I know Zillow's had a reputation for overpricing homes. But even if you could negotiate that down lower and close on it for even, let's say, $250,000, you know, you're talking about a brand new home that's cheaper than, you know, any traditional Ford home that's been on the block, been around for like 40 years. So this is actually going to be a very innovative thing going forward in the future, where really affordable houses could be printed in either traditional styles or new styles even. So the only real limiting barrier right now is roofing, plumbing, utilities, and other factors that aren't built for unique shapes or unique geometries. And I think just to be permitted in the future, print homes are going to have to kind of follow a traditional style, but it'd be nice if they could start adding printable different elements like curved corners, some different shapes that you don't normally have. This is just a quick overview of the new Silu sale for the first 3D printed home. I'll leave the link for the Silu link below. And you could also go to SQ4D to see more details on how they do that.